Definitely is one of those guys that can fill some of that leadership void that you lose with Henrik Zetterberg. You know, I think Franzi came over to us as a leader in New York. I think if anything, he's held back a little bit because of his respect to Z and to Kroner and to that. And I think it'll give him a chance to kind of make sure he's leading the way he wants to lead. So he does it right every day. He's a great, great pro, and I certainly think he's a guy who can fill some of that void.
Do you plan to use him again against opposing top lines? A little bit different look with Nyquist on there if he sticks.
Yeah, you know, I don't know that I'm stuck to using him just against top lines. I would say probably a couple different things. We've had lots of different thoughts of how we'll go about it. I think in the end, I think we're going to have to be a four-line team. I think we're going to have to play with short shifts and maybe at times worry less about matchups and worry more about aggressiveness and energy. And you know, I've got lots of options if I do want to match against the other team's best, depending on the night and a certain match. I think Glennie's somebody who's always capable of that. Certainly Nielsen is, and so is Larkin. I think Larkin's played some of his best hockey when he's done that. The one thing I want to avoid, though, is, you know, a guy like Nielsen, a guy like Larks having such a defensive responsibility that we don't produce enough offense. So those are all things I got to take into account.
Hey, Jeff, you think there's